friends and honored guests, the Grand Marshal for the School of Labor and Urban Studies 2022 Commencement Ceremony, Distinguished Lecturer Urban Studies, Deepak Bhargava. Please welcome the platform party, the school deans and chairpersons, class of 2022 salutatorian, and the administrative and academic cabinet members of the college. Please welcome the Dean of Academic Affairs, faculty of the School of Labor and Urban Studies, students, and distinguished speakers. Now, please welcome the classes of 2022. Graduates of the Certificate and Advanced Certificate in Labor Relations. Graduates of the Certificate and Advanced Certificate in Labor Studies. Please welcome graduates joining virtually. Classes of 2022, 2021, and 2020 graduates for degree programs, graduates of Bachelor of Arts in Urban and Community Studies. Graduates of the Master of Arts in Urban Studies. Graduates of the Master of Arts in Labor Studies. Thank you. All celebrants and guests, please welcome our Grand Marshal, Deepak Bhargava, Distinguished Lecturer, Urban Studies.
It is my pleasure and honor to welcome you to the CUNY School of Labor and Urban Studies 2022 commencement ceremony, celebrating the classes of 2022, 2021, and 2020. I now declare the 2022 commencement session open.
Now, would everyone please rise and remain standing during the playing of the Star Spangled Banner and Solidarity Forever. Remain standing. Before we continue the ceremony, we pause to remember all those we have lost to the mass shootings in Uvalde and Buffalo and Tulsa, to COVID-19 and the war in Ukraine. Please join us in a moment of silence. Thank you. Please be seated.
Good afternoon. Thank you. This is going to be a great commencement. It's my pleasure to welcome all of you to our 2022 commencement ceremony. Not only those of you in the room, but those of you who are with us virtually. I don't know where you went, but you were here a minute ago. But I know you're out there. Thank you all for joining us. Today is really a big deal. It really has warmed my heart to see some of you who I haven't seen in almost 3 years. It's the first time since 2019 that we're able to gather in person. And I assume all of you are as excited as I am to be here and to be amongst all of you. Over the last very difficult 3 years, our graduates achieved something remarkable. They accomplished what they set out to do and reached their academic goals in the midst of a global pandemic and all the hardships associated with it. This is really truly something to celebrate. As most of you already know, SLU is pretty unique. We're the 25th and youngest school in the CUNY system, but we have nearly 40 years of history in providing higher education to New York workers and working class communities. Our school began as a collaboration between CUNY and three New York City unions. We started with 52 students. And look at us now. We have a lot to be proud of. Thank you. Thank you. We're the only CUNY school that is explicitly dedicated to public service and social justice. Our three-part mission is unequivocal. One, we provide higher educational opportunities for working adults who want to advance their career. Two, we prepare the next generation of labor, community, and government leaders. And three, we serve the broader public by promoting discussion, debate, and civic engagement on critical social and political issues. It's a simple mission, but it's a most worthy one. Our mission, however, is nothing without our students. Since 2020, more than 400 of you have graduated. You come to us with varied backgrounds and with many aspirations. You are the workers who keep our great city humming, our streets clean, our buses and subways running, our hospitals and clinics operating, our buildings maintained, and our children educated, and our residents clothed, sheltered, and fed. Some of you are aspiring social scientists who want a deep understanding of the world of work and the urban environment. Others are activists and organizers in your unions and your communities who want to become leaders in the fight for equality and social justice. All of you, have come to SLU because you care about the common good. Whether it's about the delivery of services to the people of our city, or about addressing the policy needs of the disadvantaged, or about building a labor and social movement to bring about a more equitable and democratic society. We are very proud to have been part of your educational journey. So we're here to congratulate you on your success, acknowledge your hard work and commitment, and celebrate your accomplishments. We're also here to thank you. Yes, thank you for inspiring us, because your commitment to your education, especially during these hard times, is what makes us truly love our work. What an extraordinary and dynamic group you are. You should be as proud as peacocks. And looking out at your faces right now, I think you are. Today marks a milestone in your life, but it's a milestone that coincides with a critical moment in our history. Every day we hear about the social evils of intolerance and war and disease. At SLU, we're not afraid to name those evils: racism, sexism, homophobia, fascism, nationalistic aggression, and a capitalist system that puts profit before people and creates what were previously unimaginable levels of economic and social inequality. We live in a world today where authoritarian movements are challenging democracy across the globe. A worldwide pandemic is now in its third year, and we face unspeakable violence, loss, horror, and tragedy, both at home and abroad. So there are challenges ahead of all of us who believe in a better world is possible. This is a commencement, so you know you're gonna get advice and you know you're gonna get quotations. There are always quotations, right? So here's the first one. B.B. King said, "The beautiful thing about learning is that nobody can take it away from you." Actually, that's a direct quote from my mother. Right? She said that to me throughout my childhood. She said it to me in Greek. So you didn't know B.B. King spoke Greek, did you? So that just, you learned something about B.B. King today. Here's another quote from Toni Morrison. "If you are free, you need to free someone else. If you have some power, then your job is to empower others." So now you have a fine education, but you also have responsibilities and obligations. The events of the past few years have generated collective rage. Not enough rage by any means, but rage nonetheless. We see a renewed union organizing efforts. We see communities rising up against guns, against assaults on women's reproductive rights, against police brutality, against inadequate access to health care, and against devastating environmental damage. SLU was founded on some basic moral principles. We care about people, particularly the disenfranchised, and we care about the issues and policies that affect them. We focus our curriculum on those issues and policies, but we also focus on activism in the hope, that is, that our students can help channel collective outrage into collective action. So the question I leave for you all today is, what significant wrong will you endeavor to set right? How will you, in your own way, whether you work in government or for a nonprofit, or you're an activist in your union or community, how will you make a difference? That's your challenge, and we're counting on you taking it on. So we're here to congratulate you on your success, acknowledgement, hard work, and commitment. And despite the sobering realities of today's world, there is hope and there is happiness, and you, our graduates, bring hope as well as joy and pride to our hearts. So I'd like the graduates to please stand up for your hard work, dedication, commitment, and success. Please accept our applause. Continue standing. Family members and friends who supported them every step of the way, please stand up. You took care of the kids, you made the meals, you put up with late night homework assignments. Thank you. Please keep standing. Stand up, advisory board members whose political and financial support provided these educational opportunities. Stand up, faculty and staff who go beyond every day to make sure that our students success and graduate. This is an amazing group. It's an amazing community. And you all of you made this day possible. Thank you, one and all. Job well done. Thank you. It's now my honor and privilege to introduce to you today's representative from the CUNY Board of Trustees, Michael Arvanites. Trustee Arvanites hails from Staten Island and represents the borough on the board. He's a senior official at the New York City Board of Elections and has served as a senior staff for a number of elected officials. In his other life, Michael is a workplace safety professional working in the building trades and in the transportation industry. He trains workers and advocates for their safety. I told Michael a while ago that we were contemplating establishing the city's first labor museum at SLU, a museum that would focus on who built New York. It's really going to be a tribute to all of you who make this city hum. Just a little side note. So Michael invited me and the chair of our advisor board, Arthur Chiotis, to experience a virtual construction site at the top of a New York City skyscraper. And it was quite an experience. You know, I put the goggles on, and it was, whoa. I failed his class, clearly. We're going to bring that virtual reality experience to the museum, to the school, because we want every person that comes through our doors to really understand how hard and often how dangerous it is to keep this city humming and maintained. It's Michael's passion for workers and their safety that I think drew him to SLU, and he's been a strong advocate on our behalf ever since he first met us. So please join me in welcoming Michael Arvanites to the podium. Thank you.
All right. Hi, everybody. Class of 2022, congratulations. I am. I'm not just a CUNY trustee, Dean mentioned. I work for the city of New York too, and we make this city run. We do. Who makes this city run? We do. Who makes this city run? We do. Who makes this city run? That's right. If I lived 2,500 years ago, I would have lived in Athens. 500 years ago, before that, 500 years before that, I would have lived in Thebes. 500 years before that, I would have lived in Timbuktu. But I'm alive today, and so are you. We live in the greatest city in the world. In fact, we help run the city, the greatest city in the world. You chose to dedicate your life, like I did, to make it run better so you and I and our relatives can thrive. As the dean mentioned, you're not going to get out of here without some quotes. And since I'm Greek and he is Greek, I'm going to quote Pericles, perhaps the greatest mayor that the world has ever known. He said, all good things flow into the city. People have been down on our city lately. People have gone as far as to write the obituary of New York City. People have been writing about the death of New York City since Peter Stuyvesant left. And they've all been wrong. I would tell them to come to the CUNY School of Labor and Urban Studies. Tell me if this city doesn't have a bright, bright future, because it certainly does. You've now acquired the tools to do your jobs even better, to get that even bigger job, to make this city run even better. To those calling for the death of our city, I say they are wrong, because of people like us, because of civil servants. The trustees are so very proud to call you our graduates. You know, our mayor is a CUNY grad, so somebody in this room might succeed him one day. I hope you do. If you do, I work on campaigns, hire me. Because who makes this city run? We do. Congratulations, graduates of 2022, 2021, and 2020. Thank you very much for having me.
It's my pleasure to share with you remarks from CUNY Chancellor Felix Matas Rodriguez. But before we start the video, I want to tell Trustee Arvanites and really all of you how grateful we are to the Chancellor for his support of SLU since its inception. And how grateful we are especially for his recent allocation of additional resources so that we could lease an additional floor at our current location. It will allow us to reopen our library. It will allow us to actually put people in offices. It's a great space. All of you are gonna have to come back and see it. It's really beautiful. I also want to thank him not only for his support of the school, but for his leadership during these most difficult times. He's had a thankless job in these past 3 years, and he's worked very hard to keep the university humming. I know how hard he is and how sleepless his nights are I and other deans and presidents in the university get his emails and his text messages in the middle of the night, sometimes consecutively over the course of weeks and months. We are really looking forward to get this behind us and move the university and the school forward. So let's go to the videotape, as they say.
Greetings, everyone, and saludos. Thank you so much, Dean Macios, for inviting me to be part of this wonderful day. I am thrilled to extend my congratulations to the School of Labor and Urban Studies class of 2022 and to the entire college community. Commencement season has always been one of the great joys of my job, whether it was when I was a history professor, a college president, or now as your chancellor. I get the pleasure of celebrating thousands of New Yorkers who have persevered through an academic gauntlet and are ready to get their diplomas, hug their family, and launch their careers. It's a pure celebration of everything I love about CUNY students. Your grit and resilience, the way you overcome obstacles and make sacrifices to succeed, and how all of that underlines the thing that excites me the most about you, your great promise. As you might have heard, this year we're celebrating CUNY's 175th anniversary. It's a story that started 13 years before the Civil War with 143 students in a school called the Free Academy. It was created to educate and provide access, equity, and opportunity to people of all backgrounds. Many were the children of immigrants. Sounds familiar? You are all part of this very important New York City story. CUNY, in fact, has graduated 1.7 million students over the past 50 years alone, and many more than that over its full history. Like you, they received a quality, affordable education that prepared and positioned them to start fulfilling careers without the kind of crushing debt that burdens so many graduates across the country. Nothing makes me happier or more proud than hearing about one of our graduates who plainly says that it was the open doors of a CUNY college that served as a gateway for their success. All of them started where you are today, diplomas in hand, full of hope, and ready for the future and ready for anything. So today, you are carrying this great legacy forward. I couldn't be more proud of your resilience or more confident that these same attributes will carry you through life and be indispensable to your ambitions, whatever you have studied, or what path you choose. You have earned this recognition as much as any class going back to the Free Academy. In this, our 175th year, I am thrilled to extend my heartfelt congratulations on behalf of the entire CUNY community, present and past. You will always be part of us. Thank you, buena suerte, and good luck.
And a virtual thank you to Chancellor Matos Rodriguez. Unfortunately, Arthur Chiodas is the chair of our advisory board, could not join us today. So I'm going to use his time to say a few words about the board under his leadership and about the elected officials who support us. Although the CUNY School of Labor and Urban Studies has been in existence for only four years, the evolution of our school from worker education program at Queens College to CUNY School has been a long one, nearly 40 years. In the course of that transformation, we faced many challenges. Where would the money come from to hire faculty and staff? Would students come? We needed space for classrooms and offices, computers and audiovisual equipment. In retrospect, it looks like a miracle that we came this far, but I assure you it was no miracle. We are here today because we had the unfailing support of our labor movement and elected officials, including the governor, the legislative leaders, so many state senators, members of the state assembly, and members of the city council. I want to recognize and thank Arthur and every member of SLU's Labor and Community Advisory Board. They have lobbied with us in good budget years as well as bad budget years. They have provided tuition support for their members so that they could get this college education, and they have welcomed our student interns. They have used their considerable influence to further the social justice mission of our school, and we thank them. There is no question we could not have done this without them. So next, I'm pleased to invite to the podium and turn the proceedings over to our Associate Dean for Academic Affairs, Dr. Gladys Palma de Schneidermakers. I want to go off script a second here. you know, we have a wonderful team at SLU. Gladys is going to have the opportunity to thank everybody later in the program, but I want to use this opportunity to thank her and Associate Dean Bert Sachs over here, and their teams and their respective teams for all that they do. They're the ones that keep SLU humming and growing. So thank you all, and especially the team that put this thing together. Boy, it was a mammoth and a beautiful job you all did in this beautiful locale. So thank you all. Gladys is SLU's first Associate Dean for Academic Affairs, and we could not have found a better academic leader. She brought a wealth of knowledge and experience to the job, and she works tirelessly to make certain that all of SLU's academic and student programming helps our students achieve their education and personal goals. So please welcome a scholar, an educator, a great, great academic leader, Dr. Gladys Palma de Schneidermakers.
Thank you, Dean Mancios, for those very kind words. My grandmother used to say, "Tell me who you surround yourself with, and I will tell you who you are." So I am in very, very good company. At this time, it is my very, very great pleasure to invite to the podium Tania Caldwell, salutatorian of the graduating class of 2022, who is graduating with a Bachelor of Arts in Urban and Community Studies and a past recipient of the Joseph S. Murphy Scholarship for Diversity in Labor. Please join me in welcoming Tania.
Thank you. I promised someone that I'm going to be done in 1 minute, but it's impossible. So, greeting fellow graduated, faculty, family, and guests, and welcome to the graduation exercise for the class 2022. It is a great honor to have been selected as the salutatorian of the class 2022. And it's a deeply grateful for all the support I have received at the School of Labor and Urban Studies. Over the past 2 years, at home, from my husband and my children, and I'm so glad to have my parents join virtually from the Dominican Republic. I came to SEU 2 years ago to learn about public service. Since then, with the guidance of the school's amazing faculty, and I found my purpose in serving community. These last 2 years at SAU have been a journey for me, and as I know, they have been for most of us here today. I came to the school at the beginning of the pandemic as a part of the community semester program, which pairs coursework with community development with the opportunity to enter at the community-based organization. Realizing that there was so much more I want to learn, I applied for and received the Diversity in Labor scholarship that allows me to continue to pursue my BA in Urban and Community Study. Along the way, I was selected to serve as an officer in the SEU Student Union. Dorothy Hines, a leader in civil rights movement, once said, "Without community service, we would not have a strong quality of life. It is important for the person who serves as well as the recipient. It is the way in which we ourselves grow and develop. I, like my classmate, hunger to improve society, and my time at SEU has given me the tool to do the sort of work I was first inspired to do as a child. My grandmother was a doctor and community leader in our town in the Dominican Republic. On the weekends, she opened our house to work on low-income mothers and their children. I can still see her providing medical care for those kids with so much love. I also remember watching my grandmother working with young men who suffered from drug addiction, believing them, tried to find a way to help them to be rehabilitated. All those memories on my childhood, I carry with my heart. SEU has given me the tool to forge my own path as someone who helps and helps heals community. I want to thank Professor Lorian, the instructor on my fieldwork course, who helped me to understand the power of nonprofit organization to improve community. For community semester, I intern for an organization that connects me new immigrants to resource including English language class. I saw myself on these immigrants, and I was grateful for the opportunity to give it back. In Professor Cadora's course, Community Organizing and Community Organization, I learned new strategy for impact community, and I connected with other community organizers who brought their rich experience to our conversation. At SAU, I begin to realize that leaders are not those who we see in the TV who claim that they want to change the world. I start to see leaders around me, noted that for my whole life, I have been surrounded by effective leaders, whether on the parent association of my kids' school, workplace where workers organize to demand better conditions, and at SEU, where leaders in the student government help make opportunity more accessible for their fellow students. That's right. It is all of you who inspire me, and I know you will continue to inspire me as you work to improve your community and strive towards justice and equity. Congratulations to the class 2022.
Gracias, Tania. Thank you, Tania, for your address to the graduates and our guests. And congratulations to our class valedictorian, Indiveri Kamara Singh. I thought trying to make this was tough. I am now pleased to invite to the podium Violeta Gomez Uribe, student speaker of the graduating class of 2022, who is graduating with a BA in Urban and Community Studies, past recipient of the Joseph S. Murphy Scholarship for Diversity and Labor. Please, please join me in welcoming her to the podium.
Good afternoon. I will try to read this without passing out, but if I pass out, congratulations. Greetings, Dean Matthews, faculty, staff of the CUNY School of Labor and Urban Studies, distinguished guests, my fellow graduates, families, and friends. It is my honor to address the graduating class as a student speaker. Today's graduation is particularly meaningful. After 2 years of virtual celebrations, we can finally come together in person and share this joyous moment. This is a time to celebrate our accomplishments and a time to reflect on the challenges we faced during this journey. Attending classes while working at our jobs, taking care of our families, and many more. We all stay on the path and endure until this day, the day of our graduation. I have earned a BA in Urban Studies with a concentration in labor. My journey to arrive at this day has been full of experiences that have made me grow to be resilient and creative problem solver, thanks to my mother. When I graduated high school as an undocumented student, I never thought I would have the opportunity to go to college, let alone graduate and address my fellow graduates. Let us all acknowledge ourselves. We never gave up. And I also want to give a big shout out to the undocumented workers of New York City that also make this city run. Our education at SLU has prepared us to be better leaders. Here we have learned about leading figures like Frances Perkins, who after the tragedy of the Triangle Shirt Factory fire, dedicated her life to fight for workers' rights. She crafted the Social Security Act and the Fair Labor Standards Act as the first woman in history to serve as a cabinet secretary. We have participated in making history ourselves, learning from the outcome of the first Amazon election in history, walking down Broadway with the Deliveristas Unidos when they were fighting for better working conditions, at the Hunts Point Market picket line. I will always be grateful to my instructors for recognizing my effort and taking my work seriously enough to encourage me to continue to develop. Thank you to Professor Tsanti, whose comments on my work I still remember. Violeta, good job. Yet your paper touches on all the good points, yet you can still give more. And one day, write a book. Or in research methods, learning that my proposed research question was not a research question. Does anybody relate? But they always help us to get it right. Thank you especially to Professor Steele for encouraging me to apply for the Diversity Scholarship. Let us all thank those in our families who help us get here today. I'm very grateful for the unsung heroes in my life, and I invite you to reflect on the heroes in your own life. Today, I'm here as the granddaughter of a Bracero farm worker who picked oranges in the state of Florida, a farm worker who passed away due to lung cancer and heart health issues as a result of his work conditions. Today, I'm here as the granddaughter of an indigenous Otomi woman that never had the opportunity to go to school, yet carry her little yellow pencil in her apron pocket and use that pencil to remind her kids and the grandkids of the importance of education. But especially today, I'm here as the daughter of a domestic worker who's sitting back there. Who has not only made many professional careers possible for others, but educated many children in addition to her own. Thank you, Mommy, for your perseverance, resilience, and your unconditional love. You always taught me to avoid getting trapped in the isms, and instead to understand and allow for diversity and inclusion in my thinking. My grandfather, Jesus, taught me the same thing when he said to make sure that the table becomes longer. May we use the learnings and skills from our education at SLU to bring a folding chair to call Shirley Sism if they don't give you a seat at a table. I urge you, all my fellow graduates, to be inclusive in your own thinking, but especially in your actions, so we can welcome new voices to our table and broaden our circle as we grow in strength. Congratulations and best wishes to the graduating class of 2022.
There's nothing I can say better than that. Gracias, Violeta. At this time, I would like to recognize the student representatives of the SLU Student Union and Academic Governing Council who worked tirelessly to support all of you. Would the student representatives in the graduating class please stand for recognition? Dr. Craig Stephen Wilder is the Barton L. Weller Professor of History at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology. Professor Wilder's book, Ebony and Ivy, Race, Slavery, and the Troubled History of America's University, which in 2013, Kirkus Reviews named one of the best nonfiction books of the year, which won multiple book awards. He has authored several books and has an impressive body of work. In 2004, Columbia University awarded Greg Stephen Wilder the University Medal for Excellence during its 250th anniversary commencement. Professor Wilder is a senior fellow at the Bard Prison Initiative, where he has served as a visiting professor, commencement speaker, and academic advisor. For more than a decade, BPI has given hundreds of men and women the opportunity to earn a college degree during their incarcerations in the New York State prison system. But I have to say, all these professional, public, and academic accomplishments pale in comparison to the man and the human being I know.
Oh boy.
That's his mother calling. As a teacher, I know him to work tirelessly with his students. What is more, he is a generous colleague whose sense of humor makes all those around him feel connected and eager to participate in whatever adventure he happens to be undertaking at the time. I have known him for 32 years. We met when we were in preschool. We were five. And I deny anything else. As a colleague and a friend, he has established a new bar for achievement in the academy. I am beyond honored to introduce Dr. Craig Steven Wilder as your commencement speaker.
Okay, I did the first part. I did not fall down. All right, well, you get me. I'm substituting today, and so I've only been asked to speak at commencements as a substitute for someone else. And there's a good reason for that. I spent the last 20 years studying the relationship between American colleges and universities, slavery, the slave trade, Native American dispossession, and the destruction of indigenous nations. To put it differently, inviting me to a graduation is like inviting an undertaker to a birthday party. And so I'm gonna stick with my strengths and depress you. I wanted to talk to you about college and my college years. This is the only graduation speech I've ever given. It's the only one I will give because it's the only one I mean. I wanted to talk to you about college, but I actually don't really remember college. It's been gray for a long time. I have a sneaking suspicion that much of what I remember is false, that there are really things I wish I'd done and wish I said and wish that I actually wrote and created and rather than actually what I did when I was in college. I remember a few teachers. I remember a lot of classmates. I remember that I took a class in which we learned the succession of the popes. It was a Catholic school, Fordham up in the Bronx. I'm sorry, El Bronx. We learned the succession of the popes by dipping litmus paper into a test tube filled with 501 Spanish verbs. I think that was an economics class. I am confident that I remember graduation, because my family from Brooklyn, from Bedford-Stuyvesant, showed up wrong to graduation. No. My family showed up wrong to my graduation. My family showed up in rented cars and borrowed vans. I told my mother we only had four tickets, and she said to me with no hesitation, "I dare them to keep me out." We didn't look like we were going to a graduation. We looked like we were migrating. People had food and changes of clothes and all sorts of things. I just couldn't. On the way back, I rode home with my sisters, Terry and Gloria. We're all really close in age. Terry's about a year older than Gloria. Gloria's a little more than a year older than me. Because we were always close in age, we always went to school together, and so we were just always constantly around. Terry and Gloria looked so much alike that everybody thought they were twins, and my mother dressed them alike, which made it worse. And so they asked, "Are you twins?" "No, just Catholic." Right, one of that vast tribe of people who occasionally produce children who are like 9 months apart. And in the car ride home, we talked about the past. We joked about our childhood as if we were old, as if we had read led like Old Testament lives. I remembered them just chasing me around the house constantly because I was the youngest. They used me to practice their makeup skills. And so they would beat me up while my mother was at work and actually put makeup on me and then make me wash it all off before my mother got home. They remembered that actually when we went to school together, and we always did, anytime boys passed, I would pick, and there's no politically correct way to say this, the least enticing one and scream out, "Terry, don't you have a crush on him?" And we talked about the future. We talked about where we would live, our careers, our ambitions. That's actually not quite how it happened. We had always done that. You know, we used to sit on the stoop in my mother's house in Brooklyn and talk about the future, like what we would do when we were adults. And Terry would always choose Miss Dobson's house, the house right next to ours. That's where she was going to live. And Gloria took the Coles, which was on the right-hand side of our house, and she was going to live there. My mother would stay in the house that we were in. And I wanted to be as far away from them as I could possibly imagine being. So I chose the house across the street, where the lady who wore the white uniforms lived. She wasn't a nurse. I think she was a Pentecost. But we lived out a lot of those dreams. Terry had just gone to the NYPD as a civilian employee. Gloria had just started medical school. I was going to be applying to graduate school. Gloria became a pediatrician, finished med school, and is now my older sister and far more famous than me, so we'll skip right over her and keep moving. Perhaps I don't remember college all that well because I experienced it in a way that I no longer really cherish. We thought at that time, I thought at that time, that I had gone to college to prepare myself for the things that I knew lay in my future. Family and career and profession, a house, cats. I don't really like cats, but I just threw that in there. Cars and debt. You know, that's how we talked about our future in that car ride back to Brooklyn, back from my graduation. My older sister got ill shortly after I finished school, a chronic long-term illness that runs through my family. And that was the moment when I really came to understand the power of college. Somehow, some way, between Gloria's chemistry classes and my history classes, between her bio courses and my theology classes, college prepared us for the things we never expected or imagined confronting. Education allowed us to not feel overwhelmed by that struggle, to instead feel empowered by it, to turn to the history of my own family's struggle with that disease, with those diseases, and to reach out to other families who have the same fate. It allowed us to attack rather than to surrender. It didn't erase our problems, but it did expand the possible solutions. It allowed us to remain the three of us, a group, who would always pass through time together. It allowed us to live out our dreams and to also ensure that the dreams that she had for her children were fulfilled. And so I stand here today as a commencement speaker with the difficult task of saying something to you that's meaningful. And that's never an easy thing to do. I cannot promise any of you that your lives will be simple and unencumbered. I cannot promise you that your life will unfold exactly as you plan it today. I cannot promise you that the story that you're writing at this moment won't have twists and turns. But what I can tell you, and I can say it with perfect confidence, you are ready for that life. The power of your education will reveal itself not so much as you plan your life, but as you live it. It will steady you and carry you through lives of beauty and difficulty, filled with challenges and rewards. And CUNY will walk with you on that journey. Your classmates will walk with you on that journey. And now I get to do perhaps the most amazing thing of all, to step back and join the audience that watches you as you live that life, public and private, and cast justice into the future. Thank you.
I'm still making trouble from Bushwick, and look at me. Thank you, Dr. Wilder, for those incredible words to our graduates and their families and guests. I am now going to ask Dean Mancios to please come to the podium.
Thank you, Glass, and thank you, Dr. Wilder. I have the pleasure now of introducing three people who we honor today for their enormous contribution to the CUNY School of Labor and Urban Studies. I'd like to ask Iris DeLutro and Steve Breyer to please come up. Our third honoree is in the Netherlands attending his daughter's wedding, so I think that counts as an excused absence. But we're going to honor him nonetheless. After a lifetime of advocating for higher education, worker education, and social justice, all three at the same time, all three of our honorees are at the same time retiring this year. So I can't say really enough about their professional accomplishments or about their personal commitment to SLU, but I will try in the short time that I have to do that. The first is Iris DeLutro. I introduce her first because she was the first and only person on the staff of the Queens College Worker Education Program when we first started this program nearly 40 years ago. For the first few years, Iris and I did everything from recruiting students to monitoring office supplies to developing the union partnerships that have been so critical to our success. She also played a key role in our development when we were at Queens College. She organized 30 student representatives on the 90-member Academic Senate at the college to advocate for and ultimately win approval for our program. That was the beginning of what was to become SLU. Yeah, that was 30 students. They had 30 seats on an academic council that composed of with 60 faculty and 30 students. And Iris, being the masterful organizer that she was, got all the students and most of the faculty to approve that. And it was contentious at the time, so it was a great victory. As the program grew, so did Iris's ingenuity. It was Iris who decided we should have a Leap to Teacher program. She put her mind, heart, and soul into that project. And today we have over 800 school paraprofessionals in SLU's Leap to Teacher program at 7 campuses throughout the CUNY system. Iris became a leader of the Professional Staff Congress, the union that represents faculty and staff at CUNY, and a national advocate for Latino workers and communities. Anyone who has worked with Iris knows that she is a great speaker and a passionate and persuasive one.
I was trying to toy it off.
for those of you who can't hear it, there's a rooster crowing out there. That's your friend from Puerto Rico, right? So I was saying that Iris, has so much passion and so much soul, she can convince just about anyone to say yes. She will never say no to a student or to a union member who needs help. Iris, we are truly indebted for everything you have done to build and sustain the Leap to Teacher program and SLU over the course of nearly 40 years. So, my friend, please stay close. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. At SLU, we have the good fortune to have on our faculty two pioneering labor historians, Steve Breyer and Josh Freeman, who have distinguished careers at CUNY. Each has played an important role in the creation of SLU. As faculty members, Steve and Josh have won the affection and gratitude of our students. Each has a long list of accomplishments and special relationships to our program and to our school. Steve has worn many hats in his life at CUNY
As the founding director of the American Social History Project, he was the executive producer of award-winning multimedia curriculum, Who Built America? Inspired us to talk about Who Built New York. He has been a professor of urban education, the Urban Education PhD program, and founded the Interactive Technology and Pedagogy Certificate at the Graduate Center. On top of all that, he has done his time as assistant provost. Associate provost, excuse me. I missed that promotion. Steve's unusual combination of academic and administrative experience has been invaluable to the SLU community over the long years of our development from program to CUNY school. He was, in fact, part of a small group of us that were talking about a labor college almost 35 years ago. And when Joe Murphy, our namesake and our previous namesake, was chancellor, and it was a real viability. It was a real shame that, that group couldn't agree to move forward. It was one of those sort of mistakes we made back then. Steve and I were on the same side of that argument, but we had to wait 35 years, but here we are. Steve has brought a lot to SLU. He's also brought his love and enthusiasm for working class history, a passion for social justice, a dedication to pedagogical excellence, and a deep commitment to public education. Austerity Blues, Fighting for the Soul of Public Higher Education, which Steve co-authored with Michael Fabricant, is an essential source for students of public education. It's really a must read. Steve, thank you for your wisdom, your commitment to labor education over so many decades of service to CUNY and to its students. Thank you, Steve.
Thanks, Greg.
So let me talk about Josh across the pond there. If you haven't taken a course with distinguished professor Joshua Freeman, you've probably read his commentary in the New York Times or seen him on PBS or always talking about a major figure or event in American history. Among the most respected labor historians of our generation, Josh is widely sought for his perspective on working class America. He has written extensively about labor both in the US and globally. His interest in New York City labor has given him two groundbreaking works. In Transit, the Transport Workers Union in New York City, 1933 to 1966, and Working Class New York, Life and Labor Since World War II. Josh is also a practitioner. Lucky for us, he has merged his scholarship with active interest in SLU. He has been unsparing in his efforts to build the intellectual capacity of our school and raise its public profile. He's participated in academic governance and curriculum development, and he's represented our program to the broader CUNY community. Josh has also been a mainstream in SLU's public programming, appearing regularly as a panelist at forums and conferences and serving as a contributing editor to our journal, New Labor Forum. Josh has agreed to stay active at SLU, is serving on our board, on the board of our SLU Foundation, and has been key in our efforts to establish the New Labor Museum. We are very grateful to Josh for continuing to work with us, even as he enjoys his retiree's life. So congratulations to all three of you. Let's hear for Ira, Steve, and Josh, and don't go away. Steve, this is to you in recognition of service to the school, its mission, and students. Given on this day, June 2nd, is that today, June 2nd?
It is.
Okay, 2022.
Thank you.
And Iris, as again, the Dean's Service Award presented to Iris DeLutro in recognition of exceptional service to the school, its mission, and its students. Thank you both. Thank you. Okay. So I would now like to announce the recipient of this year's Distinguished Alumni Award, which is given to an alumni who embodies the school's mission of public service and social and economic justice for all. This year, we are recognizing Kerwin Simon, who graduated with a BA in Urban and Community Studies from the Murphy Institute and subsequently earned a master's degree in Urban Studies in SLU's class of 2021. Kerwin has worked in the New York City health care system for 20 years and is a member of CWA Local 1180. He's currently Assistant Director of New York City Health and Hospitals and the largest public health care system in the United States, where he is instrumental in ensuring all New Yorkers get an equal and fair access to health care services. So I'm pleased to present Kerwin with SLU's 2022 Distinguished Alumni Award. Please go. Kerwin, this is the Distinguished Alumni Award presented to Kerwin Simon in recognition of alumnus who embody the school's mission and given to you today on our graduation. Thank you, Kerwin. Okay, I think glass. Thank you.
The School of Labor and Urban Studies has a long-standing tradition where graduates pass the torch to an undergraduate or graduate student working towards their own graduation. Today, we continue that proud tradition with an inspirational poem written by Walter Romney, a longtime staff member at SLU, and the poem calls upon future graduates to come and to build and to show the way home. Today, the poem still defiantly rings true, and we are excited to continue this intention in 2022. Our graduate, Teresa Ramos Villa, will be passing the torch to Marlon Bailey, a current student in the master's program, Masters of Arts in Urban Studies.
As we pass the torch to the next graduates, we'd like to say, catch. A world in turmoil awaits your guiding hands. A disintegrating nation needs to be rebuilt in a new form. Come and build. Come with new ideas, new visions. We hope for a better way to live. You are now on a path to creating a brighter tomorrow. You already have the torch, so let's start moving. The world is at a crossroad. Come show the way home. Congratulations.
Okay. thank you, Teresa, Marlon, Walter, and Samina. We neglected to give our honoree a moment to speak, Kerwin, so I'm gonna invite you back on. You thought you were gonna get away scot-free today, huh? For some brief remarks, thank you.
I thought I got away, damn. So my first goal was not to fall, check. My second goal is to make my mom proud, fingers crossed. Friends and family, good evening. My name is Kerwin Simon. I stand before you as a fellow graduate and a proud alumnus of the class of 2021 and this year's recipient of the Distinguished Alumni Award. I would first like to thank the Distinguished Alumni Award Committee for giving me such a prestigious honor and opportunity. During my time at SLU, I had the opportunity and the privilege to work with so many brilliant individuals that challenged me to always be my best. I have learned so much from each and every one of my classmates, and the memories will remain with me for a lifetime. My other goal today is to address my fellow alumni, and what I say is welcome you all into SLU's Hall of Fame. No other graduating classes can say that they face the kinds of struggles like the classes of 2020, 2021, and 2022 have. We all remained focused and received our degree at a time when, a time of great uncertainty and when the world was at its scariest. I remember, and I'm sure many of you do, when SLU went from in-class to virtual learning. Oh, what a day that was. I was sitting in Dr. Kador's class when a senior administrator announced that class was moving to online. Dr. Kador, seeing the confusion on our faces, reassured us that we will get through this. I also remembered my first day of Zoom class. I positioned my computer to the best looking part of my home. You know, wanting to get that great background effect. But everything that could go wrong did go wrong. After many attempts, I was not able to log into class. No one saw that impressive background, and I missed class that night. Yet despite all those failed attempts, today I consider myself a Zoom specialist. With all that we as a group went through collectively, all the challenges we face, we remained focused on the goal ahead, receiving our degree. We all were able to withstand and recover from difficult conditions happening in the world around us, and that showed nothing will get in the way of our success. For the past 20 years, I have worked in healthcare. My capstone project focused on individuals that had limited access to services due to lack of health insurance. Today, I use my platform as a manager at New York City Health and Hospital to connect these individuals with financial counselors. I'm also able to accommodate many individuals with early appointments to help ease their pain. This may seem small, but it makes a big difference in the lives of those individuals. I know that each and every one of us are here to make a change in the world. It is a great responsibility, but one we as graduates will take in stride. So now what is our next steps? I always remember that to whom much is given, much is expected. First, finding your purpose. Now, finding your purpose can be challenging. How do you find your purpose, you ask? You know you found your purpose when what you do brings happiness and a sense of accomplishment. Your purpose doesn't have to be big. What did our capstone professors always say? Narrow it down. And when you narrow it down, they say narrow it down some more. Second, your purpose must be passion-driven. It is the intention directed through the process to create your result. And third, make positive change. We live in a changing world, one that needs our help. In a world where voting rights are being suppressed, women's rights to choose are being challenged, hatred is at its highest, communities are being displaced by massive infrastructure projects, there's a dire need for universal health care. Gun control is out of control. And the list of social injustice continues. This is our time to make a difference. We have the tools. You guys graduated. You have the knowledge. And we have the drive. Now let's safely go out there and find our passion, knowing fully well that money does not always mean success. Thank you, and congrats.
Thank you. Thank you, Kerwin. And now, what we've been waiting for, the reason why we're here, the presentation of the 2022 candidates and the graduates of classes 2021 and 2020. The chairs of the departments will now present the candidates and graduates for their certificates and degrees. To expedite the presentation of certificates and degrees, please refrain from taking photographs until the end of the ceremony. At this time, I would like to invite Dr. Stephen London, the Chair of Urban Studies. Also, I would ask our founding dean to join us as well. It is my pleasure to welcome the School of Labor and Urban Studies certificate and advanced certificate candidates of the class of 2022 and the graduates of classes of 2021 and 2020. On behalf of the Urban Studies and Labor Studies Department, I now present the candidates and graduates for the certificate programs. Will the certificate and advanced certificate candidates and graduates from the Urban Studies Department please stand and come forward? Chairperson Dr. London will stand and acknowledge the candidates and graduates. Certificate in Community Leadership. Advanced Certificate in Community Leadership, January 2022, June 2022, January 2021, June 2021, January 2020, and June 2020.
Claudia Perez. Cassandra Frith. Rashawn Donovan. Tamika Thompson. Daisy Gonzalez. Jacqueline Roberts. Nina Tinakashvili. Latoya Carter Edwards. Thomas Blocker. Christopher Fox. Wanda Nunez. Brunilda Suarez. Maria Urushima. Max Fisher. Lorena Hoti. Aflon MacIver. Leslie Kaye. Tessa Mafucci. Samantha Norris.
Okay, musical chairs. And now, Certificate in Healthcare Policy and Administration, Advanced Certificate in Leading Change in Healthcare Systems, Advanced Certificate in Healthcare Policy and Administration, January 2022, June 2022, January 2021, June 2021, January 2020, and June 2020. She read all those? Okay. All the certs have been done? Okay, my bad. My bad. Okay. An advanced certificate as well for, okay. Good, I get to speak less. Okay. Thank you, Dr. London. Will the certificate and advanced certificate candidates of the class of 2022 and graduates of the class of 2021 and 2020 from the Labor Studies Department please stand and come forward? Will the one and only chair of the Labor Studies Department, Dr. Ruth Milkman, come up to join me? What? Everybody came. Okay. All right. So, okay. All right. Okay. So all of you stay there. Ah, okay. Where are the... At this point, we would like to acknowledge the virtual graduates. Yes, yes, yes.
All right. Marie Lodescar-Francois, Certificate in Community Leadership. Nicole Nestor, Leading Change in Healthcare Systems Certificate. Eugene Patron, Leading Change in Healthcare Systems Certificate. Bernadette Anderson, Certificate in Public Administration and Public Policy. Yolanda Perez, Certificate in Public Administration, Public Policy. Lakeisha Foster, Advanced Certificate in Public Administration and Public Policy. Denise Jones, Advanced Certificate in Public Administration, Public Policy. Diamond Shamgod, Advanced Certificate, Public Administration, Public Policy. Marie Rose Jeremy, Labor Relations Certificate. Bachelor of Arts, Urban and Community Studies, Indivari Kumara Singh. Bachelor of Arts, Urban and Community Studies, Penaranda Curry, Laura Penaranda Curry. Master of Arts, Urban Studies, Arnaldo Bernabe. Master of Arts, Urban Studies, Anisha Foreman. Master of Arts, Tracy Rogers. Master of Arts, Urban Studies, Condella Stewart. Master of Arts, Urban Studies, Kenesha Williams. Master of Arts, Labor Studies, Amika Benjamin. Mark Kasner, Master of Arts, Labor Studies. Sam Connett, Master of Arts, Labor Studies. Kangela Moore, Master of Arts, Labor Studies. Wanda Williams, Master of Arts, Labor Studies. Ephigenia Demopoulos, Master of Arts, Labor Studies.
It's my pleasure to welcome the School of Labor and Urban Studies candidates of the class of 2022 and graduates of the classes of 2021 and 2020 for their degrees. On behalf of the Labor Studies and Urban Studies departments, I will now present the candidates and graduates for their degrees. Our chairs are on the stage. Bachelor of Arts in Urban and Community Studies, January 2022, June 2022, January 2021, June 2021, January 2020, and June 2020.
Kofi Bentham. Angelique De Jesus. Karen Martin-Burrow. Brian McTiernan. Also, Tanya Caldwell and Violeta Gomez Uribe.
Master of Arts in Urban Studies, January 2022, June 2022, January 2021, June 2021, January 2020, June 2020.
Tanya Caldwell and Violeta Gomez Uribe, please.
Vincent Apraku. Neon Amir. Chantel Atarian. Ashlyn Barrett. Bibi Braid. Kishay Brown. Daryl Innes. Kahinde Sane. Robert Johnson. Aislinn Klein. Anne Lowe. Evelyn Lucero. Yasmina Moore. Vanessa Mosley. Evichama Munaja. Veronica Peters. Miriam Philip Joseph. Antigua Middleton. Mirto Pierre. Ricardo Rivera. Sean Robinson. Lizette Ruiz. Thank you. Uriel Océan Souffrant. Aditi Vazbravstein. Carl L. Walton II. Stuart Wong. Gary Ragelbeer. Kerwin Simon.
Will the candidates and graduates from Labor Studies, from the Labor Studies Department, please come and stand and be recognized by your chair. Masters of Arts in Labor Studies, January 2022, June 2022, January 2021, June 2021, January 2020, and June 2020.
Virgilio Aran. Elaine Blair. Tamika N. Brown. Yvette Burke Forehand. David Cumberbatch. Kevin Curtin. Brandon Davis. Alan Island. Kendra Fowler. Pedro Freire.
Yeah, I think you
Crystal Garcia. There's a lot of excitement on the stage. Frida Garza Garcia. Berhe Gil Lewis. Maria Nelly Geraldo. Glenn Guild. Robert Hardman. Noelle Hill. AJ Hubbard. Liana Coleman. Anshu Kadka. Oh, Margaret Kwateng. Alaysia Laureano. Xiomara Luarte. Ariam Lopez. Chris Mejia. Pablo Perez. Nicholas Pineda. Gabriela Quintanilla. Teresa Ramos Viega. Anna Rivera. Alana Salwin. Haley Schaefer. Robin Thompson.
Finally got to be in person.
Kaylee Truman. Yolisel Vargas Lopez. Sharice Winley. Natasha Yee.
Wait till the line settles down a little bit. As you can see, the love among our students and faculty, the hugs and the tears for all the amazing accomplishments. I'm just letting the line get a little bit so we can proceed with the conferral of the degrees. Oh boy. You know what? I'm gonna. And now, the conferral of certificates and degrees. Will the candidates and graduates please stand? Dean Mancios. Wait. So we still have a few more taking pictures. You can stand and get applause. You deserve all the applause in the world today.
You're gonna read these and then I'm gonna read these.
No, no, I read everything, and then what you do is you read.
Okay. Yeah, they have me doing it again. Right, and then what's this?
You confirm. You should say that you read something.
Right. Okay.
We're almost there, folks. Now, this is a good problem to have. Look at all these graduates here and virtual graduates as well. Okay. Dean Mancios, on the recommendation of the faculty of the School of Labor and Urban Studies and their respective departments, I present to you. Okay. All right. I present to you the candidates and graduates for the certificates and degrees of Certificate in Community Leadership, Advanced Certificate in Community Leadership, Certificate in Healthcare Policy and Administration, Advanced Certificate in Leading Change in Healthcare, Advanced Certificate in Healthcare Policy and Administration, Certificate in Public Administration and Public Policy, Advanced Certificate in Public Administration and Public Policy. Patrick, I'm sorry, I'm a New Yorker, I speak fast. And for the first time ever in the school's history, Advanced Certificate in Workplace Democracy and Community Ownership. Certificate in Labor Relations, Advanced Certificate in Labor Relations, Certificate in Labor Studies, Advanced Certificate in Labor Studies, Bachelor of Arts in Urban and Community Studies, Master of Arts in Labor Studies, Master of Arts in Urban Studies for January 2022, June 2022, January 2021, June 2021, January 2020, June 2020.
So for this part, we're going to wait till everybody can join us. I want to, while we're waiting, I want to just thank the committee that put this special day together. I want to thank Dean Bert Sachs for getting us this wonderful venue. I want to thank Nellie Benavides. I want to thank Rochelle Bindercoffey, Patrick O'Donohue, and an entire team that worked tirelessly to put this together. I'd also like to thank Nana, who's somewhere here. Nana Ama, my assistant, who has been invaluable. This takes a lot of work, and it's worth every second because I know for me, it's the best part of the academic year is to see all of you out here with your families in the background. It gets our juices running and gets us ready for another semester. I think we're about ready. Nope. Okay. We want to get all those smiley faces and proud faces on camera. Right. Okay. I think we're all here. So you may recall we left off with Gladys recommending these candidates for their certificates and degrees. So here comes my part. This is all very specific here. So I'm gonna make sure I get the wording right. Associate Dean of Academic Affairs Gladys Palmer de Schneidermakers, Faculty, Class of 2022. 2, candidates for graduation and graduates for the classes of 221 and 220. By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of the City University of New York, I hereby confer all of the degrees and certificates offered today. Congratulations. And this I do with all the rights, privileges, and honors appertaining thereto. Graduates, as a symbol of your new status, please move your tassels from right to left. Congratulations. Thank you. Please be seated.
Okay, I know we kind of did this a little bit earlier, but you know, I'm an immigrant and I was raised in Bushwick, Brooklyn before it became West Williamsburg. Hello, Bushwick in the house. So we're gonna really represent right now, right?
Yeah.
Okay, today we celebrate the accomplishments of our graduates. However, no commencement would be complete without recognizing those individuals who have been instrumental in bringing about our graduate success. So right now, will the administrators and staff please rise? To the administrators and staff who tirelessly assisted and supported our students in navigating their own path through the school, thank you. It is my great pleasure now to ask the faculty to please rise. Teacher, challenger, taskmaster, co-explorer, mentor, counselor, and friend, core of our institution, pulse of the academy, singularly and collectively, you have provided our student body with an extraordinary educational foundation. Please accept the sincere gratitude of the entire SLU and CUNY community. Thank you. All right. Now, I spoke to the family members early, told you were going to have a role in this, okay? Well, the parents, spouses, partners, children, and other family members of our graduates, please rise. Your support, encouragement, patience, sacrifice, and financial assistance, let's be real, made today possible. You are most deserving of our gratitude and thanks. On behalf of the School of Labor and Urban Studies, please accept our heartfelt appreciation for entrusting to us those who are so precious to you. And now, to my graduates, please stand. You are the best of us, our hope for the future. This is your moment. Grab it, take it, seize it, change the world. It belongs to you. Congratulations.
We now officially declare the 2022 commencement officially over. Congratulations, graduates! Now, before we exit, we have a very special announcement from graduate Nick Pineda. Nick, will you come up on stage, please?
Thank you, sir. So I've been at this school since its inception, so I've seen many of your faces, and I'm very grateful to all of you, faculty, staff, Gladys, the queen. And I developed a family here over the last 8 years. Many of you are part of it. And I just wanted to say thank you to everyone and make you a part of my extended family. And so, Noel Hill, if you could come up to the stage, please. Got some for you.
Will you marry me? Welcome to the family.
See how we roll around here. You come for a degree and you leave with something else. So, congratulations, Nick and Noel. We're all so happy for you. So, as we come to a close today, we want to ask folks to please allow the graduating class to exit first, followed by faculty and guests. Graduates, you're going to follow the commencement ambassadors over here to the library steps at 5th Avenue and 42nd Street near the famous Lions for a photo of the graduating class. Thank you very much. So let's let them exit first. Thank you.